Good morning, boys and girls. How are you doing today? I hope you're well. Have you been enjoying being out in the snow? It has been just beautiful, hasn't it? Have you seen the pictures, the amazing pictures of the snowflakes and all their amazing detail? It's just been fantastic to see. Now, thank you for coming to Junior Church today. It is really lovely to see you. Thank you for spending this time with us. We are going to be looking this week at Jesus Saves, and our topic this week is called Jesus Forgives and Restores. So we're going to have great fun looking at that today. Now, if you check out the email that this came through in, you will see that there is various worksheets that you can use and you can work through, and there's various ones for the different ages. So have a look at that and you can just do a bit more of thinking about the story and praying about the story in your own time. But it's lovely to have you with me this morning. So let me just pray for us and then we'll begin. Heavenly Father, I thank you so much that you have brought us together in this way. And even though we can't meet in person yet, we can still come together to learn more about you and to be challenged about how we live our lives, what we think about you. We just thank you so much for that. We thank you for all the boys and girls in our junior church, whether they're watching this morning or not. We just pray your blessing on them, your protection over them, Heavenly Father. And we just pray that as we go into our midterm holiday, that you are helping us to have some rest, Father, even though our actual situations might not be changing, just that you would give us rest and you would help us to be refreshed for whatever the next school term brings. We thank you so much for your blessing on us. We pray, I pray, Heavenly Father, you're with me this morning. You help me that all the words I use are from you and it's not about me. But we just pray that we would learn more about you today. Amen.
You're here with me. I know that you're listening to all my dreams deep down inside. You're teaching me who I'm supposed to be, the hidden things. And
watched the lesson last week. Do you remember what it's about? It was about, it was about one of the disciples. Can you remember which one? Can be tricky sometimes to remember. It feels a long time ago last Sunday, doesn't it? Well, our story last week was about Thomas, one of the disciples. And you remember that Jesus had come back after he'd been resurrected, and he came back and he visited the disciples, and he showed them that he was alive again, didn't he? But there was one disciple that hadn't seen him yet, and that was our friend Thomas. Now, poor Thomas, he was a bit wary of believing his friends, the disciples, wasn't he? Because he hadn't seen it for himself. And he said, unless I can touch the nail holes, and unless I can touch Jesus' side where he was pierced, then he wouldn't believe it. And Jesus was so kind to Thomas, wasn't he? He appeared before Thomas and he said, okay, Thomas, you can touch my hands and you can touch my side. And Thomas was so thankful to see Jesus again. And Jesus told us that those who don't get to see him and don't get to touch him and still believe are blessed, because they believe through faith. We believe even though we're not seeing it and physically touching him. So that was last week's story. Now this week's story, we're going to see the third time that Jesus appeared to his disciples, which is when he is on the shore of Lake Galilee again. Now please watch closely to the story. I hope you enjoy it.
Days after Jesus died on the cross, he came back to life. More than once, Jesus appeared to his disciples and proved that he was alive. One day, Jesus met his disciples while they were fishing on the Sea of Galilee. Peter and the other disciples got into the boat and spent all night on the water, but they did not catch any fish. The next morning, as the sun was coming up, Jesus stood on the shore. He called out to the disciples, but they did not recognize him. Jesus said, "Men, have you caught any fish?" "No," they answered. "Put your net in the water on the right side of the boat, and you will catch some fish," Jesus said.
The disciples did what Jesus said. So many fish were in their net that they could not pull the net back into the boat. One of the disciples said to Peter, "It is the Lord." Peter tied his clothing around himself and jumped into the water so he could swim to shore. The rest of the disciples traveled in the boat back to the shore. They pulled the net full of fish behind them.
When the disciples got out of the boat, they saw bread and a charcoal fire with fish on it. "Bring some of the fish you've caught," Jesus said. So Peter pulled the net ashore. It was full of large fish, 153 of them. "Come and have breakfast," Jesus said. Jesus took the bread and gave it to them. Then he gave them the fish. This was the third time Jesus appeared to the disciples after he was raised from the dead.
Jesus turned to Peter. "Do you love me more than these?" he asked. "Yes, Lord," Peter said. "You know that I love you." "Feed my lambs," Jesus told him. Jesus asked Peter again, "Do you love me?" "Yes, Lord," Peter said. "You know that I love you." "Take care of my sheep," Jesus said. Jesus asked Peter a third time, "Do you love me?" Peter was very sad that Jesus asked him a third time. Peter loved Jesus very much. "Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." "Feed my sheep," Jesus said. Jesus told Peter that he would bring honor to God. Then Jesus said to him, "Follow me."
When Jesus first called the disciples to follow him, Jesus had promised to make them fishers of men. Instead of catching fish, they would tell people about Jesus. The disciples had left Jesus when he was arrested and even denied him. But Jesus still wanted to use them in God's plans. Jesus is the Lord who forgives us and makes things right again.
Now, at this point in the story, boys and girls, we can see that the disciples have gone back fishing, haven't they? I wonder why they have done this. Do you have any thoughts on that? I wonder what you think about that. I think they've maybe gone back fishing because they just don't know what else to do. Remember, at this point in the story, Jesus has died and he was resurrected, and they have seen him again, but they're still not quite sure about what they should be doing, about where they should be going and who they should be talking to. So they've gone back to what they knew before they met Jesus, and that was being fishermen. Now, when Jesus comes alongside them on the beach, on the shoreline, he's reminding them of what he called them to do in the first place. Way back when he first called his disciples, he told them to follow him and he would make them fishers of men. So now he's reminding his disciples, he's restoring them to the place that he had got them to before he died. He is reminding them that they have a great calling. They have to go out and save people. They have to spread the good news of Jesus. And that's not just a calling for the disciples 2,000 years ago. It's a calling for us today to go out and tell people the good news about Jesus. And that is it's scary, but that's an amazing thing that God has called us to do, and one that we should be thinking about. How do we tell our friends about Jesus? It's a challenging one, boys and girls. I'm not going to lie to you. It is challenging, but we have to be brave for Jesus, don't we? Sorry about that interruption, boys and girls. My phone ran out of storage, so I've just had to go and spend time deleting so many old photos and videos so that I could finish my junior church. So, where were we? We were talking about the second part of our verses today in chapter 21, and that is where Peter and Jesus are having a conversation. And you'll remember that Jesus is asking Peter, do you love me? And Peter's saying, of course I love you. And then Jesus gives him a command. He gives him something to do. Look after my sheep, feed my sheep, look after my flock. Now, I wonder why he's doing that, boys and girls. I wonder, boys and girls, have you ever done anything naughty? Have you ever done anything that's a little bit wrong, that maybe you knew you shouldn't have been doing? And have you ever had to say sorry and ask someone to forgive you? Well, that's a little bit like what's going on here, isn't it? Just before Jesus died, Jesus told Peter that he would deny him when it came to it at the end of the day, when he was under pressure, that Peter would deny that he knew Jesus. And Peter said, no, of course I won't, because I love you. But that's exactly what happened. And we see these just a few verses earlier. So Peter denies Jesus 3 times. So a girl is saying to Peter here, you are not one of the disciples, are you? The girl at the door asked Peter, and he replied, I am not. And then, as he stood warming himself, another man asked him, you are not one of the disciples, are you? And Peter denied it, saying, I am not. Just reading here from John 18. One of the high priest's servants, a relative of a man whose ear Peter had cut off, challenged him, didn't I see you with him in the olive grove? Again, Peter denied it, and at that moment, a rooster began to crow. And that's when Peter suddenly had the realization that Jesus was right. Jesus had said that Peter would deny him 3 times, and he had, and he was very sad about it. But in this story, when Jesus appears to him and asks him 3 times, do you love me? And 3 times Peter says yes. That is Jesus forgiving and restoring Peter back to the amazing disciple that he was. He's bringing him back into the fold. And it's a way of comforting Peter and saying, of course you're forgiven. Of course you can still serve me. And it would have just been such a comfort to Peter. Now, boys and girls, there are lots of things that we do wrong in this life because, you know what, we're human and we're sinners and we're not perfect. And I want you to know this, just how much Jesus loves you, just how much he wants to be part of your life. There is nothing that you can do that he won't forgive you for. There is nothing you can do that would make Jesus not love you. I just want you to really know that, boys and girls, that he loves you so much and he wants to be part of your life. And that is such an amazing thing to know, that there is nothing you can do that can separate you from God. So we are going to now do one of our worship songs. So I hope you enjoy it.
So mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. He made the trees, he made the seas, he made the elephants too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. So strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do. The mountains are his, the valleys are his, the stars are his handiwork too. My God is so big, so strong and so mighty, there's nothing my God cannot do.
Now, boys and girls, and it's called the 5 second quiz. So I'm going to put some questions up and you have got 5 seconds to see if you can remember the right answer. Let me know how many you get.
boys and girls, I just want to say a big thank you for spending this morning with me. Remember, you can look on the email. There is lots of different sheets and activities for you to do at home based on today's lesson. So I hope you enjoy those. Let me just pray for us as we close. Heavenly Father, I thank you so much for the truth contained within your word, that you do forgive us, that there is nothing that we can do that would separate us from you. Heavenly Father, I pray that you would help us to really just be aware of our actions this week and see places where we might be particularly sinning, or there is something that we need to say sorry for. Father, I pray you would convict us. Would you help us to see that in our lives and to make the change to ask for forgiveness, Father. I thank you so much for every boy and girl in our junior church. I thank you just so much for them. And I just pray so much that they would have such a desire to get to know you better. I thank you so much for the way that you have blessed us all, the way you take care of us and just look after us. We thank you so much. In your precious son's name, amen. Right, boys and girls, thanks again so much for being with me. I hope you enjoy your February half term. Whether you've got a couple of days off or a whole week, I hope you have a great time. So take care, everyone. Bye now.
You have made me glad.